हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माय नेम इज विभा शर्मा। इन लास्ट क्लास वी डिस ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द प्रोटेक्टिव टिश्यू ऑफ द परमानेंट टिश्यूज। नाउ द सेकेंड कैटेगरी ऑफ द परमानेंट टिश्यू दैट इज द सपोर्टिंग टिश्यू। इन परमानेंट टिश्यू द सेकेंड कैटेगरी दैट इज द बी सपोर्टिंग टिश्यू। इज द नेम इंडिकेट्स दिस टिश्यू हेल्प्स इन द support of the plant. First of all, it is of three type, that is the parenchyma, collenchyma and sclerenchyma. We discuss the first type, that is the parenchyma. Parenchyma, this tissue first of all evolved in the bryophyte, and these are the thin walled cells, generally oval or spherical in structure. The cell wall mainly composed of thin cell walls, and these cells, thin cell walls, which are made up of cellulose and pectin. Basically, the deposition of the cellulose occurs in the parenchyma. They provide the turgidity to cell, and the main function of the parenchyma is to storage of the food. If the parenchyma helps in the food storage, then it is called as the prosenchyma. If it is stored food, then it is known as the prosenchyma. Next, some parenchyma involved in excretory substances, storage are called as idioblast, and they store materials like resin, tannin, gum and oil. So that are the idioblast. While in parenchyma chlorophyll are present, then the chloroplast is known as chlorenchyma, because it helps in the photosynthesis. So parenchyma containing chloroplast. Called as chlorenchyma, which helps in the photosynthesis. If parenchyma contains air spaces, then it is called as aranchyma, which helps to maintain the buoyancy, especially in hydrophytic plants. Aranchyma. Next is the collenchyma. Collenchyma basically provides the, its main function is to provide the, it's a mechanical tissue, living mechanical tissue. Next is second, that is collenchyma. It is a living mechanical tissue, because sclerenchyma is the dead mechanical tissue. That's why it is important to note that it is a living mechanical tissue. These are thick walled due to the deposition of cellulose and pectin. Thick walled due to localized cellulose and pectin thickening. It provides the elasticity to the growing stem, so it is responsible for the easy bending of the plants. If it is not present, then the breaking of the stems due to the strong air current occurs. So it is important that it is present in the plants to provide the easy bending to plant during the strong air current. This is about collenchyma. It is generally present in the herbaceous dicot stem and at the margin of leaves. Next is the third category, that is the sclerenchyma. Sclerenchyma is the dead mechanical tissue. It is a dead mechanical, tissue, thick-walled and these are thick-walled and dead. Thick-walled, why they are thick-walled? Due to the deposition of subarine lignin substances. That's why basically the thick-walled cells and due to deposition of lignin. Or we can say that lignified cell walls due to deposition of lignin. Next is the, there is no intercellular spaces in the sclerenchyma. This lignin is a waterproof material. And the cells of the sclerenchyma, cells of sclerenchyma is of two types, that is the sclerates and fibrous. Sclerates and fibrous. Sclerates, these are also called as the grit cells or stone cells. Basically present in, example is pear, coconut, walnut and walnut. These are small cells where lumen is so small because of the higher thickening of the cell wall, as present in the coconut, walnut and mango also, as well as in legume seeds. So these are the sclerates or grit cells or stone cells. Well, if I'm talking about fibers, these are the long, narrow, thick lignified cells. Here the lumen is large as compared to sclerates, and generally they are 1 to 3 mm long in size. And in the thick walls of both the fibers and sclerates, they are present a thin areas which are called as the pits. Suppose this is structures, these are the long, and these pits, they have no deposition pits, they have no deposition of lignin and all. That's why in the lignin cell wall, which is a dead cell wall, but these pits are due to no deposition of lignin, these cells are the living cells and living pores, which is responsible for the conduction of the material in and out of the fibers and sclerates. So these are the pits which are present in the sclerenchyma. They are also found in the manufacture of the rope, mat and the certain textile fibers also. So sclerenchyma fibers have a role in the commercial purpose. That is for commercial purpose. So this is all about the permanent tissues, the supporting permanent tissue type of supporting tissue. And next we started about the complex permanent tissue. Let's revive once again. What are the different types of permanent tissue? That is, the first is the supporting tissue. Supporting tissue, as the name indicates, it the main function is to support in the plant. It is of three type: parenchyma, collenchyma and sclerenchyma. Parenchyma first evolves in the bryophytes, and they are the thin cell walls which are made up of cellulose and pectin, and on the basis of the food storage, if parenchyma function is to store the food, then it is called as prosenchyma. If parenchyma contain the chloroplast, then it is called as chlorenchyma. And if the chloroplast is present in something, then obviously the function is the photosynthesis. So chlorenchyma helps in the photosynthesis. While if parenchyma contains the air spaces, then it is called as aerenchyma, and they are basically responsible for maintaining the buoyancy in the plant during the floating, to maintain the position of the plants. The specific type of tissue present, which is called as aerenchyma, which helps to float in the in the water. So it is basically present in the hydrophytic plants. Next category, that is the collenchyma, which is the living mechanical tissue, and they are thick walled due to deposition of the cellulose and pectin substances. But here the main deposition is of cellulose, while it provides the easy bending to the plant. Suppose if strong air current occurs in the environment, then if the plant do not allow to movement, means the branches, if the branches are not moved, then the possibility of breakdown of the branches is more. So Kallenkeimer function is to provide the easy bending to the plant during the strong air current. That is the must function for the Kallenkeimer. Next is the sclerenchyma, which is the dead mechanical tissue. So, the main mechanical tissue basically, which provide strength to the plant. And these are thick wall cells due to the possession of lignin substances. This lignin substance is a waterproof material because they are dead cells and they do not possess any kind of intercellular spaces. They are completely thick wall substances and they are composed of two types of cells, that is the sclerites or grid cells or stone cells, and the other type of cells, that is the fibers. So if I'm talking about sclerites, then it is found in the pear. When we eat pear, then some stone cells like substances comes in our mouth. That is the sclerites. Basically, that are the grid cells or stone cells. And it is also found in coconut and walnut, as well as in fibers. In sclerites, the lumen is also very small as compared to the fibers. While in fibers, the lumen is large and it is long, narrow and thick lignified cells, basically responsible for the formation of jute, mats, coir and fibers. So that are important in the commercial purpose. And during the in the structure of these sclerenchyma, due to the deposition of lignin, all the cell wall is the dead. Obviously, the cell wall is the dead part due to deposition of waste substances. Lignin is also an S substance which makes the cell wall dead. So, in this lignified area, some non-lignified area is present, because if it is not present, then how the substances regulate in and out of the cell? So, these are the unlignified area on the lignified walls, and that are called as pits, which is responsible for the regulation of substances in and out of the cell. That's all for today. Next time, we will discuss about the complex permanent tissue. Thank you.